Open source is great. As a software engineer, you know how important it is. You use it every day in your job now, programming software, to feel good. You would like to contribute back to the community, but you often feel like you don't have enough time between all the clients' deadline at work and the family and kids and trying to stay active in between. There's never enough hours in the day, right? So what would you say if I told you that you could contribute to open source projects during working hours? You might think that's impossible, that most of non-developers, managers, or executive teams will see this as a waste of time, the time that you're not billing to a client. And you'd be right, but there is a way. In this video, I'll share some tips on how you can convince your boss to let you do just that. Work on open source projects between 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. So first, we'll try to convince your manager by playing with emotions and feelings. But if this doesn't work, watch until the end, where I'll give you more tips and the killer option using real hard data and facts to try and make your case to your line manager or your board of directors so that they too can start embracing open source projects during working hours. Let's get to it. Hey, my name is Sylvain Reiter, and on this channel, I share tips to help you as software engineers or digital professionals to get promoted by making better decisions on your next digital project. So if you are lucky, you'd have a good manager who's potentially an ex-developer and has grown into management, and they would understand the benefits of open source. And this is where you can use three different emotional arguments and to try and let you contribute during working hours. First, it's only fair to give back. You have to remind your manager about the benefits of open source, the freedom from vendor lock-in, and how the global community is contributing and continuously improving the quality of the software that they use. Second, it's good for your personal development. It's like free training, so which manager wouldn't like that? You will become a better developer. You'll be able to better communicate in a team and work collaboratively with strangers, so that's a benefit as well. And finally, it's good for your well-being and your mental health. In this day and age, with all the rumors about quiet quitting, and I think that working on open source will bring tons of positive feelings about doing some good in the world and help others. So hopefully that will be enough. However, most of the board of directors will make business decisions based on numbers, based on their bottom line. And they might understand the cost savings of open source. Yeah, it's free. But they don't usually understand the business benefits of their team contributing back to open source. So you can try the emotional arguments as just mentioned, but you might need to get a bit more analytical and come up with some data, strengthen your case, and turn the arguments not to the benefits to you, but the benefits to the company that you're working for, to the directors. The first one would be to show that you are benefiting from it as a business. A recent study from the Harvard Business School demonstrated that companies who contribute to open source projects reap 100% more value from their software investment when compared to companies who simply use software without open source software without contributing. I think it would be useful to show all their products are using open source. Show the management the number of lines of code in their project that is using open source, looking at the repository and all the modules you're importing, even if they don't know about it. And instead of waiting for code fixes on some of the repository that you use, you might as well influence the software yourself by assigning some active contributor to work on it. Even non-developers can influence priorities by making feature requests or contributing to documentation on someone else's repository. Second, this will benefit their sales effort of your company, because some clients do care about it and they ask for it in public sector tenders, for example. So becoming known in the industry and using those credentials for client pitching can only be good for your company's brand name, and if you publish your own open source modules and build a community around it, around the project, it will strengthen your overall brand. Third, would help with staff retention and attracting new talents. As I said earlier, it's like free training for your team of developers. And I have seen it in our own team when we give them a few hours every week of uninterrupted focus to give back. They feel a higher sense of purpose and they really appreciate the allowance, which becomes a strong staff retention benefit. And you can also meet some of the best developers around those projects, and you could end up working with them in the future. The fourth and the final tip I promised you at the start is time tracking. Because one important metric in development teams is the number of hours working on clients' projects and the overall productivity of the team of developers. And your goal will be to show that you can fit this open source contribution without affecting your billable hours. Most businesses will have some target or KPI for how much you should spend or to bill a percentage of time that you need to spend on specific clients' projects. So as long as you are above that target, they won't have a case to stop you. And you need to focus on efficiency, on delivering quality, on the best features that you can as quick as possible, and stick to your estimates. And that should give you some spare hours to contribute to open source. And that should keep everyone happy. So that's the goal. So that's it for today. I hope you found this useful. Don't forget to subscribe and let me know in the comments below if you're going through this struggle, or if you don't know how to approach this specific conversation with your manager, or if you overcame it already and how that's gone. So now it's your turn, it's your time, go for it. Start small, contribute to documentation or translation. Just start somewhere and start resolving some of the issues in your favorite open source repositories that you use. Next, you should watch this video to learn how to optimize the value and the efficiency of your software development project and deliver better digital solutions. Until next time, stay safe and see you soon.